In this video, we'll go over how to apply deep learning on LiDAR data for tasks such as object detection and semantic segmentation. Deep learning is used to help perceive the environment in autonomous driving and robotic applications by identifying and classifying objects in the scene. For demonstrating deep learning with LiDAR, we'll follow an example from MathWorks documentation that uses a deep learning network called PointPillars for 3D object detection on point cloud data. PointPillar networks addresses some of the common challenges in training robust detectors like sparsity of data per object, object occlusions, and sensor noise by using an encoder that can learn representation of point clouds organized in vertical columns as pillars. This is the workflow followed in the example. First, we load the data and then pre-process it. We then define the PointPillar network, followed by training the network on the pre-processed data, and finally, we test the network to evaluate its performance. Let's start by downloading PointCloud dataset from this URL. The dataset contains around 1600 organized PointCloud scans of highway scenes and corresponding ground truth labels for car and truck objects. This ground truth data was labeled using MATLAB's LiDAR labeler app. You can load PointCloud data to the app, define cuboid bounding boxes around the object, automate labeling with inbuilt or custom automation algorithms, and then export it into MATLAB workspace. We'll pre-process the loaded data in three steps. First, we'll crop the full view point cloud to the front view point cloud or the ego vehicle perspective. This will reduce the size of data and in turn decreases overall network training time. In the second step, we'll split the data into training and testing set. We'll use file data store to manage the point cloud. A file data store is an object that helps to manage collection of custom format files that are too large to fit in memory. We'll then create another data store for loading ground truth labels with 3D bounding boxes. In the third step, we'll perform ground truth data augmentation, which will randomly add fixed number of car class objects to every point cloud. This technique will improve network accuracy by synthetically increasing the size of training dataset. In addition to this, we'll use additional augmentation techniques such as flipping, scaling, rotation, and translation. Next, we'll build the PointPillar network to train on this data. A PointPillar network accepts point clouds as input and estimates oriented 3D bounding boxes around the object. It consists of three main stages. A feature encoder that converts a point cloud to a sparse pseudo image by converting point clouds into pillars and then using a simplified version of PointNet network to learn a representation of point clouds organized as pillars. A 2D convolutional backbone to process pseudo image into a high-level representation, and a detection head that detects objects and creates 3D bounding boxes around them. We can use command lines in MATLAB to construct this network using inbuilt deep learning layers like input layer, convolution layer, deconvolution layer, batch normalization layer, max pool layer, and ReLU layer. Next, we'll define training options like number of epochs and learning rates. We'll set the execution environment as auto, which will allow to train the network on a GPU if available or otherwise uses a CPU for training. Training PointPillar on the entire dataset takes a long time. So for now, I am loading a pre-trained PointPillar network to detect objects on LiDAR data. We can now load the test data and apply the trained network to generate bounding boxes on identified objects. Finally, we have our objects detected on point cloud data. Here, the red bounding boxes represent predicted objects and green bounding boxes are the ground truth labels. You can see that they are very close, which means our model's prediction is reasonably good. Follow the links below to learn more. If you have any questions or comments, please let us know.